Hello there, everybody. In this video, my version of XY edge and center finding.
3, 2, 1.
And setting it up in Mach 3.
Tool 0 complete.
If you have yet to do so, watch my previous Z-axis video for setup and settings up to this point. Also, I use Mach 3 version R3-043-066. Some versions below this may not run the included scripts correctly. I recommend watching this video all the way through before committing to the setup. Alright, XY probing. I have it set up on the offsets screen, in the edge finder and gauge block sections. Besides changing the visuals a bit, we're going to give it 4 individual edge finding scripts, an external center finding script, and an internal center finding script. Okay, to set it up, close Mach 3. In the video description, you'll find a link to download my XY touch scripts zip file. Once opened, place the JPG image files in Mach 3's bitmaps mil bitmaps folder. If you want to keep Mach 3's original files of the same name, you're going to have to rename them. Otherwise, just overwrite. Okay, open Mach 3 and let's code the buttons. We'll look through the scripts shortly. For now, just load them and save them. And use the same cut-paste process for loading the other scripts. Individual edge finding. For this example, I'm using aluminum tape as my conductive gauge, and we're going to locate corner 0, starting with Y. Double check that the system is ready. And go. Once contact is made, the tool will back off and set the DRO accordingly.
Tool 0 complete.
Reposition the tool for X and go.
Tool 0 complete.
And with that, XY0 is located. These 4 individual edge scripts are identical to each other when it comes to the user variables. And as in all of my scripts, millimeter or inch mode is automatically detected. And for safety, millimeter inch values need to be equivalent. If you want a delay between button click and machine movement, it goes here. And if you do use a delay, then at 5 seconds and below, it will speak the countdown. Of course, change it to your preferences. A note about the speech. If you notice it lag compared to the visual countdown shown on the status line, then you'll have to either increase your computer's voice speed or switch to the beep. If you want a WAV audio file to play when a script is finished, include its full path here. And don't forget the quotation marks. This particular audio file, by the way, is from the previous Z-axis video. Okay, probe diameter, or tool diameter in my case. If you have a certain size that you use all of the time, or most of the time, enter it here. To use that default, make sure the edge finder digital readout is set to 0 before clicking any of the auto buttons. If you want to temporarily override your default setting, say for a different size end mill for example, just type it in the DRO and go. If you often use various sizes for tool setting, you can set the default to 0, then always provide the diameter. Gauge thickness, which I have set for aluminum tape. Sometimes, however, I use the conductive shim, and sometimes no gauge at all if the part is conductive. As with the probe diameter, to use your default, make sure the DRO is set to 0 before clicking auto. To override, supply the new value and go. In the case of not needing a gauge, entering any negative number will signal a no gauge condition. The negative sign itself is the no gauge trigger for the script. The number is ignored. As with the probe, setting a default of 0 will require you to always provide the gauge thickness. In this case, just leave the DRO set to 0 for the no gauge condition. Okay, nothing below this user variable area need be edited. Nonetheless, I did include code comments to make it easier to find a given area if you do need to edit. And forget not to edit the user variables in the other three auto scripts. Some notes here. Be very aware of the current unit mode when entering values. Switching between millimeter and inch modes will not automatically convert them. Also, upon initializing these auto scripts, the status line will show the probe and gauge values entered that are to be used for calculations, and the units detected. The original functions of these two DROs are still intact. You can still use manual edge finding and manual Z setting. Click center if indicating a circle. Ignore that whole thing. Internal center finding. Choose an axis. Set a delay if desired. Rapid positioning. Unchecking this will slow all retraction moves to twice the approach feed rate. I sometimes do this for short distances and or if I need to use my conductive gauging.
All right.
Tool 0 complete.
Okay, the part's X center is located and XDRO zeroed. Extra info in the status line, the span length. Another example, finding center of a milled slot. With this slot's orientation, I recommend first centering X, then Y. You can do this individually, or in one
fell swoop.
Tool 0 complete.
In the event that a slot is oriented along the x-axis, I would first run y, then x. Again, you can do this individually, or tick this box to reverse the order of the combo. Alright, locating circle center. For this, it doesn't matter what order you use, but taking is circle will run two cycles. The first cycle for centering, the second cycle for fine tuning and measuring.
Tool 0 complete.
Okay, X and Y are zeroed at center. Extra information in the status line includes the calculated average diameter, along with an idea of how out of round the circle is. That is, the difference between the X and Y spans. If the difference value is crazy high, whatever that might be to you, run the circle again just to be sure the tool is centered. The variables. Maximum travel. For both X and Y, I have these set to 75% of my CNC's full travel. Default probe and gauge. All rules previously explained about these DRO overrides also apply here, and to external center finding, which we'll get to shortly. All options in the Options dialog can be set to a default position. This just means one or a few less button clicks before hitting OK. Again, code comments are aplenty if you need them. Alright, let's hit some external center finding. External center finding. Some preparations are required for a crash-free experience.
I'm only laughing because I've crashed it, okay? Alright.
Z0 must be set at top of part or above, whichever has a clear path across the part.
In this case, with 0 set at top surface, I'm cleared in this area for X, and these areas for Y.
Another way is to move the tool somewhere over the part above all obstacles, such as this clamp, then 0Z. This location, plus your default standoff distance, is the height at which the tool will travel across the part.
At this height, I'm free to check for X center anywhere along the part.
Alright, with that set, move to the negative side of the part, X negative in this case, and drop Z to your preferred touch height. Whatever you do, do not reset Z0 here. This location will be captured by the script and used on the other side of the part. Alright, the machine itself is ready. Okay, here the status line says gauge 0. That is the default setting that I have set in the script, but I'm using aluminum tape. So I need to enter the override. The options dialog. Approximate span. This is the approximate length or width of the part or section of the part that you want to find the center of. In this case, it's just under 3 inches, so we'll say 3.
It's okay to overstate the measurement a bit, but never understate.
Alright, let's run this part.
Tool 0 complete.
X center located. DRO zeroed. Let's set up to find Y center. Z0 is still set, so we just need to reposition the tool to the Y negative side of the part. Okay. We're at 2¾ inches this time, and locating Y.
Tool 0 complete.
And with that, part center X and Y are located. And if you need to, reset Z0 for the job at hand.
Tool 0 complete.
For the rotary axis users, this script is also handy for locating rotary axis center. Okay, the variables. In addition to the usuals, span hold. This serves two safety purposes. First, it buys you time to prepare gauging.
3, 2, 1.
Second, if you plug in the wrong values and your span falls short,
3, 2.
You have time to terminate the script via the escape key before the tool plunge ruins your day. Safety gap. When the probe reaches side opposite, the safety gap is the distance between the inward side of the probe and the gauge, or the part if you're not using a gauge. Again, all dialog options can be set to a default. And that just about covers it. Note here that all of these scripts capture certain modes and values when they are launched. Some or all of these will be changed or canceled during script run, but will be restored when probing is complete, unless script run is interrupted via the escape key, e-stop, power outage, or acts of nature. Make sure to dry run all scripts to verify that they will work as you expect. And always test gauge or part conductivity so you know Mach 3 can see it. And one last thing, I use parallel port setup, so I'm not sure how these scripts will work for USB connected machines, so I would appreciate feedback on that. Have a good day.